Hello everyone and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 3. We are playing as France still. It is the 10th of March 1942 and things just got bloody interesting down here in the Balkans. So things are getting a little bit fun down here. We have a bunch of help from the Brits. I'm just going to unpause here. We have a bunch of help from the Brits in this area. Basically, we're relying on the British Marines and one corps of actual French troops to do our fighting for us. This is the 14th Corps down here, led by a guy whose name I can't pronounce. Yeah, not even gonna try. We have retreated to the mountains, basically just given up all of the north of Romania, and we're hoping that the Romanians will be able to help shore up our eastern line over here, and that the Germans just throw themselves against us, and that we're able to hold them back. We do have the advantage of extremely good territory. We're defending at like 190% efficiency, and they're only attack... Well, these guys are actually attacking fairly well. Oh, this is our hill province, isn't it? Let's see. Yeah, this is our hill province. So this is the one that we're most likely to get kicked out of. That said, they are still facing some pretty nasty penalties, and we're defending rather efficiently, actually. We've got good experience modifiers on both of our units. We're dug in to the max amount of modification. They will probably be able to just... completely walk over us if they get enough troops in the area. In the meantime, we are engaging in some aerial combat over here, which isn't always a good thing. What is going on? Oh, okay. Those are the British airplanes in the area. And now they're trying to bomb Copenhagen, apparently. And our... Yeah, we need to stop. No! No! Don't die. Apparently 0% is not dead yet. I don't want to lose him. Well, he's still there. He's still there, and I don't want him to just go away. Hopefully 0% strength doesn't mean that there are absolutely none left and that it's just absolutely demolished and we can't repair it. Yeah, I'm gonna speed it up a little bit more, just because I think we're in good positions down here. We don't really need to do any counterattacking. We're gonna do good work down here. We're gonna put up a good fight. Over here, they're just throwing their men away. I don't know why they even continue to attack here. They're just hemorrhaging organization over here. Let's go back to the these guys. Okay, we have 1% strength. All right, we're just gonna let these guys chill here for a bit. We've won this battle. Look at that. Look at that death ratio. That's spectacular. Yeah, it looks like they are just going to continue to dump troops into this fight. We might need to retreat from this province. And unless Romania can get more reinforcements up here, we do have these units in back, so retreating in good order will be not too much of a problem. In the meantime, we're going to put up a good fight here and give them what for. We don't necessarily want to lose all of our organization, trying to hold on to provinces that we know we won't be able to hold on to. Like, this is the hill province, and we do get much better bonuses in the mountain provinces. But at the same time, we don't want to make it free for them, you know? We don't want to just retreat the first sign of something going wrong. Okay, so this is the 40th Division of Infantry. This is actually one of our units. It isn't fully upgraded yet, unfortunately. Actually, let's prioritize all of these units for upgrades and reinforcements, since these are the ones actually in combat right now. And yeah, we're going to retreat these units. Let's retreat them here. And this is also another... Yeah, this is also another French unit who's doing much better, probably because they have a much higher experience ratio, but they are going to get pushed back as well. At this point, we're really just putting up a token fight here. There's no way we're going to be able to hold against this many divisions. They are able to attack us from three provinces, so yeah, we're gonna just cut our losses and retreat there. It's unfortunate, but it happens. In the meantime, our multi-role fighters are doing fairly well over here. There have been 19 bombings in this province, but that's green, so that means that we're doing the bombing, or one of our allies are doing the bombing. Three air battles here, one air battle over here. We're making them pay for their bombing of us, which is a fantastic thing. And these guys are on air superiority, so they're just going to fly around making a nuisance of themselves. We should probably get some interceptors over there to support them. We'll use these units. What's your range? 300. So... So these guys have 425 range. If we base them here, that's 150. So it'd be 150 kilometers just from this airfield up here. And then probably another 150 to the front line. I think it's worth it to... Yeah, there are 8 units based here already. We don't want to overwhelm this airfield. I think it's worth it to move the longer ranged units back down here to Varna, and then move our interceptors, where are they? These ones. Up here to Bucharest. They're going to get intercepted on the way over, as per normal. But they should be able to get here in good order. That will tank their organization, unfortunately, and these units' organization too, since we rebased them. But I think we can afford to continue the air superiority. They do have limited range now, but that's okay. We didn't want them doing air superiority all the way into Romania anyway. Yeah, I think that should be okay. And then we'll set these guys on air intercept. So when our air superiority fighters get engaged, these units will jump in and help them. Should be good. So we have 7 fighter wings, 3 multi-role, and 4 interceptor wings. Hopefully we should make them absolutely pay for any amount of bombing that they do to us. Retreating in good order here. Unfortunately, we are retreating into the mountains, so their speed is going to be remarkably reduced. That said, we have mountainous terrain to defend from, so I think we'll be all right. I am worried about our eastern flank over here. That's going to be the point of contention. We don't have good, well, we don't have as good territory over here to defend our line. So it's going to be a little bit of a challenge on this side, and we really don't have anything in reserve. We might need to pull more units. Really don't want to. Because at this point, we've got this core up here. Yeah, we've got this core up here. And we have one more core that we were going to use to come over here and help the Netherlands, but we might just need to pull... Yeah, let's do that. We'll pull the 6th core from the front line over here, so they won't be the ones advancing up. We'll use them... We'll drop them off as soon as we can, and we're going to need to take the 2nd core from the Expeditionary Army and add it to the East Euro Expeditionary, because we need as many... We need help over here. So yeah, we're gonna need to pull them out and just basically use them to hold this line right over here. It's gonna be our weak point. Of course, all that will be moot if they manage to kick us out of our mountains anyway. Where's this? Hey, they're bringing mountain core to the fore. These units attack just fine into mountain terrain. Luckily, it doesn't look like the majority of German troops are mountain units, so we shouldn't need to face too many of them. We do still have fairly significant bonuses to our defense. It's just these units don't take any detriments, really, to their attack into the mountains. I'd really appreciate it if you retreated a little bit quicker, so you could start getting your organization back. Unfortunately, we sent the really, really damaged one into this province, so they're not going to be able to help too much. And in fact, they may actually end up being pushed out of this province completely if they do manage to get to the front line before we reduce this unit. Are we... Oh, that unit has no supplies, yeah. Yeah, makes sense. Keeping an eye on our transports, heading through Gibraltar now. And the Expeditionary Army is really only in charge of the Dutch Corps at this point. You're the East Euro one, so you're the ones who we want to put on the boats. Yeah, I'm confident in our ability in this province. I'm sort of hoping that these units don't get to the front, actually. And we have more production at our fingertips, which probably means we need more aircraft. Okay, you're doing okay. I'm going to do more multi-rolls. I think they're going to be our sort of saving grace. They've got higher range and not quite as much air attack, but they have more air defense, so they're going to be better against the German Air Force, which is probably going to be more heavily armored. Those are heavy armored divisions. Oh, okay. They're now attacking across the strait with the Hungarian troops. Look at that organization go away. Just gone. Just absolutely gone. Well, that was easy. Got some air combat over here. Just look at this absolute massive French Air Force demolishing the Hungarian bombers. It's wonderful. It's a wonderful thing to see. Okay, so now they're down to negative 2%. Yeah, okay. That'll be fine. It's still an expensive fight because they were using mountain troops, but now these units will be able to... Oh, did they re-engage? They did re-engage. We're going to need to do a counter-attack here. Let's leave the really damaged one behind, actually. Oh, that's not good. Not good at all. Okay, yeah, that is not going to work. Never mind. Forget what I said. I think these units will just need to hold out on their own. Yeah, the infantry division got pushed back already. It will regain organization while it's retreating. We really can't afford to lose that province, though. So we're going to need to reinforce, preferably from a different province. I mean, they're only at 28%, but we're already down to half organization just because they can throw so many more units into this fight than we can. We really can't afford to be giving up the mountain provinces over here. How are our transports doing? East Euro Corps. Yep, all of you. Rebase. Get over here. We need you. We need you right now. Hurry up. How long will it take you? 9th of April? Like 10 days? Throw them all in. And we've just been pushed out. Wonderful. And they're attacking us up here. How are we doing up here? We've got a whole bunch of Romanian units that aren't doing too hot. Hopefully we'll be able to push them out of that province again. We don't have to... I mean, that's a really... That'd be a really easy thing to just surround there, wouldn't it? Maybe impossible to hold over here. We're doing okay in this fight. Can't complain too much. And this fight is not doing too horribly. Interceptors are still doing okay. How about our multi-rolls? Eh, you're getting a little bit damaged, but you're doing alright. Okay, so we lost this province. They can just move right down here and completely cut us off. Which is not a good thing. Our units are regaining organization. They've almost pushed Romania all the way back out of the north of their country. I suppose it may have been a stupid decision to take those hills. Push them out of here. Their attack on here was stopped. They're still attacking us over here. We're doing okay. We don't really have reserve troops, though, is the problem. And it looks like they're pushing the Romanians out. I do think we need to focus on taking this province back. Industrial production advance is always a nice thing. Once again, this is a secondary front, you know? It's not going to be the end of us if we lose Romania over here. What we want to do is make it as expensive as possible for the Germans. And keep our eyes open for them. Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen. Never mind. They're never going to withdraw troops from this line. It's just not going to happen. We do have you back up and running, though, so we'll move you over here. Good stuff. Where are our transports? They're almost here. Well, we sort of need reinforcements over here. And we sort of need to do a counterattack as soon as physically possible. Where's Bran? Yeah, they're attacking us here now. Should be able to put up a good fight over here. Pushing us all across the front line. I mean, look at the sheer amount of German troops we have to face. Aircraft are doing okay. We are sort of being pummeled all across the line, though. They're attacking over here now instead. All right, our troops are here. They're out of supplies because reasons. So, where are we going to deploy them? We need backup up here. We need backup up here. And we need to shore up over here as well. Prevent them from making this into a gigantic pocket over here. We just beat them, and they're attacking us again. They just have way more units than we do. They have the ability to just continually attack and attack and attack until we're completely out of men and manpower organization. But we do have another 50,000 French. Another 50,000 troops coming up into our position. Let's see. Looks like they have two units here. Three units, I guess. We're holding out fairly well. Can't say that I like it. We're able to push them out. Yeah, I mean, I'm glad that our convoys are doing a good job up here. I'm glad that we're holding them in Denmark. We are making a good name for ourselves, but I don't think that we'll be able to hold up against these medium panzer divisions. I think we need to focus on withdrawing from this little pocket over here, and a pocket is exactly what this is, so we're going to start pulling our HQ units out. Actually, I think strategic redeployment is the mood for the day, and we're going to start pulling these guys back, and these guys too. We'll retreat them to this province. Maybe we can hold them here. I don't know. Shorten up the line at the very least. I think so that we have less frontage to cover. You're waiting for fuel. Hey, veteran army! Better organization rate is always a very nice thing, and that gives us a little bit more leadership as well. So we can dump that. I do think that let's cut back on this, get as close to 14 as possible without going over. There we go. The rest of these being bumped up just a little bit is perfectly fine, but we have another research project we can take advantage of. I think infantry morale is gonna be it. Unfortunately, we're fighting with a lot of British troops, so these upgrades that we've been working so hard on don't exactly matter too much. Okay, I think our air orders are no longer relevant because we've been pushed back so darn far. We are doing a fairly good job of engaging them when they show up. So let's do just one of these things instead. We'll let our interceptors rest for a little bit. And our reinforcement infantry is getting up to the line. You guys definitely need some reinforcements. Yeah, you continue moving in there, and you'll be the stopgap for right there. I'd love to take this province, because that would be a nice mountain province to hold our line with. But I don't think that pushing them out of the mountains is necessarily in the cards. I mean, they are pretty darn weak now. We may actually be able to force our way in there. But not with these units. They are too weak, too disorganized. You're doing okay. You're doing just fine. That's fine. That's fine. Push them back again. Amazingly, Romania is still managing to hold on to that north half of their country. Continue to move back. I mean, another big problem is that this is mountain territory, so even retreating is going to take a significant amount of time. Look at that. The 23rd of April? My goodness gracious. So we need to hold on to this province. We need these guys to come back here. My goodness. 3-1 kill-death ratio. It's pretty darn good, I have to say, but... how long will it take you to move in there? Too long. Strategically redeploy. No? Why not? Can't. Okay, well. Whatever. This is a little bit disconcerting. Don't want to lose another mountain province. Looks like we might not have a choice. Okay, as soon as all of these units are good to go, we're gonna do our best to push our way back into this province. So that means tomorrow, looks like. Tomorrow sometime. These units aren't going to arrive after retreating in very good order. We've been pushed back in that province. They're poking holes everywhere, aren't they? We're going to need you to retreat at some point, too. So it looks like this whole shorten the line here idea isn't going to work too well. So yeah, we need to pull out. We're going to need to pull out of here, too, but I'm not going to give up this province just yet. Not until these units get out, okay. Yeah, now you're gonna be hit pretty hard from all sides. We are putting up good fights though. Look at that organization loss. It's pretty good. I still think we need to do counterattacks here. Pretty good counterattack, I have to say. We're gonna take some significant losses, unfortunately, because we're attacking into the mountains. But we sort of need to get these guys out of here as soon as possible. What is this attack? Why are we attacking in Bran? Stop. Oh, you're moving up. Okay, no. Don't do that. Let's not be suicidal about this thing. You're still retreating in good order, which is a good sign. Okay, and now the 48th Brigade isn't actually in frontline combat, so we can retreat them without any difficulties. You units still haven't gotten out of that province. Looks like the 22nd we can actually retreat, so we need to hold this province until the 22nd, at the very least. Negative 59. Their organization is pretty darn low. I think we will be able to take this province. Just give them a little bit of help. Maybe we'll be able to push this one back too. Romanians still holding on up here, which is a good thing. Won't be for too long, I don't think. Unless the Soviet Union has declared war yet? No. We can declare war on them, but that would be pretty foolish of us, wouldn't it? How you doing, Germany? Yep. Same as normal. Okay, well, at least Italy is not yet in this war, so we don't have to worry about them. And Yugoslavia hasn't turned on us either, so that's a good thing. Okay, so we'll get this unit out into Orsova. And once you get there on the 18th, in looks like 3 hours, we will retreat from this province as well. There we go. And pull back. Don't fight where you don't need to. What's this? Hey, more British infantry. Wonderful. We'll attach you to the 2nd Brit Corps. Good stuff. And we'll send our transport over here to pick you up. I'm sort of divided now over whether to continue to pull more troops off of this front, because this front's been very static. And Germany seems to have deployed most of their troops down here. So if we can keep them down here, that would keep them away from the Low Countries. That's a darn good thing. So, like, can we support our 1st Armored Corps down there? Can we support more infantry down here? Is it worth going all in down here in Romania? I mean, we're getting into the plains now where we've basically already lost the really easy to defend territory until we get down here into Bulgaria. But we can put up a fairly good defense if we were to continue to reinforce this front, not just rely on 2 French infantry corps and then a hodgepodge of British infantry. I don't know anymore. I don't know. I think we do. I think we need to go all in. We'll send another infantry division once our transports get over there. It's going to be slow to reinforce, but hopefully we can push back the Germans. We're doing fairly well. They do dramatically outnumber us still. But we're getting good help from Bulgaria and the like. Once these units have retreated and we give them a little chance to reorganize, hopefully we'll be able to hold this line, push a little bit back, and take back that mountain province too. Taking back this one was a good thing. Retreated here. When will you get there? A few days. Good stuff. They broke off their attack in Lupeni over here. You will get there on the 22nd. And you will get there on the 21st, so that's a good thing. I've been attacked where? Right here. This is the province we just pushed them out of. Marine unit was the first one to get there. We actually want to leave you here, unfortunately. Yeah, we need to now dig in and prevent them from taking this province back. Luckily, we get the awesome defense modifiers, but that may not matter if we can't get our troops to the front line. Okay, we've finished upgrading another one of these. Attached you to the 2nd Armored again. How are y'all doing? Upgraded, 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 upgraded. Alright. So now we have a fully upgraded 2nd Armored Corps. Got 2 more units down here. I guess we'll start pulling these units off. Bring them down this way. Upgrade to mechanized. And now we're starting to lose rare materials, but only because we're also trading it away to some of our allies. So I'm not too worried about it. We do sort of need to take this province and hold it, so please get up to the front. There you go. Wonderful. Now, please win. Now you need to win. That's also rather desperately important. No offense, but win. Okay, let's get our close air support over here. Which ones are you? I haven't been renaming our air groups, unfortunately, so I just need to go through all of them. There you are. What's your range? 215. We need to put you darn close then. I guess overburdening this one too by just a little bit isn't that horrible. Okay, we've retreated in good order down here. Just a few more days and one more day. 5 o'clock. Exactly 24 more hours and you'll be retreated. And we can start pulling back from this position if we need to. I mean, I don't want to give up a mountain if I don't have to. But this is not a good spot to be defending in. Like, this is pretty bad spot to be defending in, honestly. The only plains province around. So we are going to continue to pull back. It is going to leave these guys a little bit overexposed, but that's all right. I'm not certain we'll be able to hold this. You'll get there soon enough, but will you get to the front before these units are forced back? And will you be enough? I'm not sure you will. We can't afford to do a counterattack, especially not with these poor units. I haven't even been resupplied yet. Okay, it's just you now. You're here, but you're not on the front line yet. Luckily, you're a French division, so your reinforcement chance is pretty darn high. But will it matter? We're being attacked to the north now. We've got one pushed back. You're almost at full again. Too many units to push out with just R2 infantry. How's our transport? Not quite there yet. Just around the coast of Portugal. I don't think it's gonna happen. Nope. Okay, we've been pushed out of the province we just took. So maybe that was not the best decision on our part to even attempt that. Definitely need to get out of here. Okay, so we've been pushed out of here again. These units need to retreat and keep retreating, I think, to ensure that we don't get surrounded. We got our close air support. Oh my goodness, they got so beat up. Our interceptors have no orders, and multi-rolls are not doing too bad, actually. So yeah, we'll let our close air support just kind of chill for a bit. We're doing fairly well in terms of bombings and air battles, so I don't feel too bad setting these guys a rather ambitious air intercept job. Where are our transports? Come on, transports, go! Go, go, go! Better reliability for our medium tanks is always good, and we might as well continue with that. Yeah, don't have anything against researching that a little bit more. They are attacking us here, but it's only Hungarian troops, so I think we'll do okay. We are going to retreat our really damaged ones, though, because they need to get out of there as soon as possible. The longer they can spend in supply, the better. Better infantry anti-tank weapons is always nice. That does mean we have a whole bunch more infantry upgrades to do. I'm not going to research jungle stuff. We'll just throw these over here in the fighter category, I think. What's this? Need less for reinforcement, but more for upgrades. I'm sure that number's going to skyrocket here in a bit. Our transports are done. And yeah, we're just going to take everybody. Another 5 infantry divisions might not seem like much, but it's probably better than nothing, hopefully. Hopefully I'm not just throwing more and more units over here in what is essentially a fool's errand, you know? We are putting up a good fight, though. We're holding the line. Okay, so they broke off this fight, yes? No, they haven't yet. We're just trying to let our really damaged units get out of this province. Hold this corridor open. Looks like that's becoming increasingly difficult. How long will it take you to get out? 1st of May. We need to keep you here. You all retreated here, which is probably for the best. Alright. We need to basically hold off as long as possible in this province. Interceptors doing their work. Good stuff. How you doing still? Close air support's not doing too hot. And there's the upgrade cost. Yep, 44.07. Woo-wee. Okay, so we stole a infantry division from the 2nd Army. So that might not be best. We could very easily still be forced completely out of Romania. Germany is a tough cookie, but while we're fighting over here in the Balkans, I'm fairly confident we won't be fighting up here in the Low Countries. I mean, they don't even have enough troops up here to even take on the Netherlands at this point. If they were to declare war, they need to completely redeploy all these troops, which is a distinct possibility. That said, the closer we get to, 43, 44, the closer the Soviet Union gets to just being fed up with Germany and attacking on their own. So, I think I'm going to take a break here. Thank you much for joining me again in another episode of Hearts of Iron 3. And I'll see you all next time.